Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the presentation of the colors and remain standing for the national anthem and the invocation.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, bless this final gathering of this cadet's family tonight as we bid farewell to those of our brothers and sisters who in a short time will be leaving us as they prepare to enter the next era of their lives. We will never forget what they have taught us through their example and personal sacrifice for us and our future. We thank you for the gift of the Holy Spirit, which has given us the will to accomplish things most of us thought possible just a few short months ago. You have watched us over us and helped us to achieve these very difficult tasks, which have given us a new confidence both in ourselves and what we are capable of doing when simply working together towards a common goal. We thank you for these gifts and strengths and self-worth and pray that you continue to guide us towards what you will us to do. We ask these things in your name. Amen.
Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated.
Captain Castro, please stand up. Cadet Castro will be our company commander next year. Cadet Captain Alexis Lopez. Cadet First Lieutenant Ruben Crosno. Cadet First Lieutenant Danielle Louie. Cadet First Lieutenant Alberto Miranda. Cadet Staff Sergeant Christopher Klein. Cadet Staff Sergeant Virginia Coker. Cadet Staff Sergeant Jesse Urias. Cadet Corporal Katrina Gonzalez. Cadet Mass Corporal Jonathan Marma. Cadet PFC Mariah Pena. Cadet PFC Casey Barkley. And Cadet PFC Jessica Vasquez. At this time, I'd like the Staff Sergeant Serrano to come up and present some awards. Thank you. Once again, thank you everybody for being here. 1994, actually 10 years before that, 1984, the school board had a vision of having a very important JROTC program here at Selma High School. It took 10 years for the high school to finally, the curriculum to finally say yes. Other opportunities for other mentioned services were available. For 23 years, our program has been viewed as one of the best JROTC programs in the Central Valley. Over the past 23 years, our program has been recognized for 19 years as a Naval Honor School, being one of the top 20% programs in the region. For the second year in a row, and the third time in school history, our program has been recognized as the number one Marine Corps JROTC unit in the Western region. Female team finished third in the state.
recognition. Will the class of 2015-2016 school year please stand? All LE2s and above. American Legion Bronze Medal for Scholastic Excellence Upper Class. Top 10% of academic standing, top 25% of the MCJROTC program. Demonstrated qualities of leadership, participated in extracurricular student, academic, or sports activities. Cadet First Lieutenant Reuben Crosby. Lower Class. Cadet Lance Corporal Antonio Alonso.
Thank you.
Jessica Vasquez. Daughters of the American Revolution of 1812 Bronze Medal, awarded annually to a graduating cadet, top 25% of the senior class, including MCJROTC program, demonstrated qualities of dependability, good character, and adherence to military discipline, leadership ability, and a fundamental and patriotic understanding of the importance of JROTC training. Cadet Private First Class Casey Barkley. Military Order of the World Wars Bronze Medal, awarded annually to a first-year cadet, excelled in military and scholastic activities throughout the year, being good standing in all classes, indicated desire to serve the United States, and committed to enroll in the MCJROTC program for the following year. Cadet Lance Corporal Samuel Lopez. Military Officers Association Bronze Medal, awarded annually to a junior who is a cadet officer or is holding an officer's billet, top 10% of all academic class, A average, and MCJROTC. Cadet First Lieutenant Danielle Louie. involved in at least one extracurricular activity or organization. Cadet Private First Class Christina Wallace. Cadet Sergeant Olivia Leala. Cadet Staff Sergeant Jennifer Martinez. Cadet Staff Sergeant Virginia Coker. Association. female cadet in at least the second year of MCJROTC. Satisfactory academics, citizenship, and community service record, and have the highest female grade percentage in MCJROTC. Cadet Sergeant Marina Alvarez.
Solid civic responsibility, welfare.
25% of academic class, demonstrated and encouraged patriotism, and is enrolled in the next year of MCJROTC. Cadet Sergeant Aleda Martinez.
Loyalty and dedication to the program.
Student Leadership Award, awarded annually to a cadet holding an elected office in the school's student body. Cadet Sergeant Lolita Pialba, Cadet BOC Casey Barkley, and Cadet Lance Corporal Geneva Mendoza. Officer Leadership Award, awarded annually to cadet officers who have demonstrated exceptional leadership, discipline, character, military bearing, and military proficiency. Cadet Captain Alexis Lopez, Cadet First Lieutenant Ruben Crosby, Cadet First Lieutenant Danielle Louie, and Cadet First Lieutenant Alberto Miranda. Best Drill Cadet Award, awarded annually to the cadet with the highest mastery of close order drill within each platoon. Cadet First Sergeant Michael Romero, Cadet First Lieutenant Desiree Rodriguez, Cadet Sergeant Lolita D'Alba, Cadet Sergeant Samantha Louie, Cadet Corporal Jesus Mendez. Distinguished Scholastic Achievement Award, awarded annually for the attainment of a minimum 3.5 academic GPA. Cadet Captain Mia Castro, Distinguished Military Training Award, awarded annually to cadets in all levels with proven mastery of the MCJROTC curriculum, involvement in the MCJROTC extracurricular and community service activities, and who have demonstrated both leadership and selfless service. John Garcia. Cadet Lance Corporal Angel Durantin. Cadet Lance Corporal Antonia Alonzo. Cadet Lance Corporal Jonathan Cleve. Cadet POC Jedediah Espina. Cadet POC Savannah Barajas. Cadet POC Alejandro Montes. And Cadet Private Anthony Castillo. selection of the best drill squad. The best drill squad is determined through competition with other drill squads in the unit to be superior in the following categories: manual arms and military veteran. Platoon commander for second period, Cadets First Lieutenant Desiree Rodriguez. Drill members for that squad are Cadet Lance Corporal Jaslyn Lopez, Cadet Lance Corporal Samuel Lopez, Cadet Lance Corporal Isabella Ramirez, Cadet Lance Corporal Ulysses Reynaga, Cadet Lance Corporal Mohit Nar, Cadet Lance Corporal Kathy Vega, Cadet POC Elijah Izar, Cadet Private Anthony Castillo, and Cadet Private Evelyn Lopez. Cadet Staff Sergeant Virginia Coker. Cadet Sergeant Lolita D'Alba. Cadet Sergeant Emmanuel Abundis. Cadet Sergeant Miriam Garcia. Cadet Corporal Robert Flores. Cadet Corporal John Garcia. Cadet Lance Corporal Antonia Alonso. Cadet Lance Corporal Angel Durantes. Cadet Lance Corporal Jonathan Clee. And Cadet Lance Corporal Stephanie Lopez.
Cadet Staff Sergeant Gabriel Rios and Cadet Corporal Stephanie Lopez.
Christina Gonzalez, Cadet Corporal Daniel Leva, Cadet Lance Corporal Stephanie Lopez, Cadet Lance Corporal Geneva Mendoza, Cadet Lance Corporal Alexis Reynaca, Cadet POC Alejandro Montes, Cadet Private Jasmine Bernal, Cadet Private Alex Cavalon, and Cadet Private Paul Rodriguez.
Everything that's going on, so not Dr. Louie, I know her. made chips, last minute things. So, and I have certificates from them also that I'll be delivering. And also to my husband, John, who's always supported me, even though he says, don't do it.
Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the benediction and then remain standing for the retirement of the coaches.
Let us pray. Almighty Father, whose command is over all and whose love never fails, make us aware of thy presence and obedient to thy will. Keep us true to our best selves, guarding us against dishonesty and envy, and helping us live so that we can face our fellow Marines, our loved ones, and thee without shame and fear. Protect our families. Give us the will to do work of a Marine and to accept our share of responsibilities with vigor and enthusiasm. Grant us the courage to be proficient in our daily performance. Keep us loyal and faithful to our superiors and to the duties of our country and the Marine Corps entrusted to us. Make us considerate of those committed to our leadership. Help us to wear a uniform with dignity and let it remind us daily of the tradition which we must uphold. If we are inclined to doubt, steady our faith. If we are tempted, make us strong to resist. If we should miss the mark, give us the courage to try again. Guide us with the light of truth and grant us wisdom by which we may understand the